And he leads the team that's making the game. So that's a good sign. Juan, come on, how's it going? Wake up, people. How are you doing? All right, five people are awake now. We're getting started. Let me introduce myself. Hi, my name is Rohan. You probably know me as the guy from AIB who's not Tanmay. That's how most people recognize me. But today is not about me. Today we're here to talk to Alia. And they said that somebody should talk to Alia and interview her. They said there is only one natural choice in mind, and that person should be Karan Johar, but he wasn't available. So then that's how I came on board. But without any further ado, you know her. She needs no introduction, but I want to take a second to do it because I was like, how do I introduce Alia? And I said, let me just look back to her previous calendar here. And just March to March last year, she's had Kapoor & Sons, Udta Punjab, Dear Zindagi, and Badrinath. That is a career that most actresses would be proud of, and she's managed to do it in a year. So with no further ado, to talk more about her game and about a bunch of other things, please welcome to the stage, Alia Bhatt.
Very far away from me.
I'm very far away. No, yeah. This is what they said. They said I have to sit here.
This is not how we usually sit together.
Yeah, that's true. Usually we don't, but lots of people running around under fire. This is why they told me to stay away, so they can have a neat frame of just you with absolutely no disturbance. So first of all, welcome. Thank you for being here.
Thank you.
First things first, belated happy birthday.
Thank you very much. You just had your birthday.
Everybody wish her a happy birthday. Come on.
Thank you so much.
Did you have fun? What did you do?
I got a cat.
You got a cat? Wow.
His name is Edward.
Okay.
And I ate a lot of cake and a lot of food.
Okay. So tell us more about Edward. Is he fun? We've seen him on your Instagram, but...
Oh, he's like a piece of my heart. He is the love of my life. It's almost difficult for me to even leave him at home right now and come here. But because it's a very, very special event, I have to be here. But I really miss Edward. And I want to be with him all the time.
Why Edward? Why the name Edward?
You know, because I'm tired of calling cats like by cute names,
right?
Or like animals like boo, koo, choo, loo.
Huh.
I mean, you know, we need something royal. So I was like, kuch royal rakhte uska naam.
Nice. So that's why Edward.
Yeah. So Shine and I were like, nah, you know, we want to keep. So Shine wanted to call him Felix.
Right.
And I said, no.
That's a very typical cat name.
Yeah, it's a cat name. And then we, I think, came to Edward together. And
Nice. Okay, cool. So I'm going to name my next cat Ramesh. Like just to give it a nice normal name.
Or Bijoy.
Or just something like that. Yeah. Or just like Sunny. Or just give it a name like that. That'll be fun. So I want to jump into it straight away I was thinking about what to ask you. And the first thing that occurred to me is, yes, you're a very good actor and all of that. But there's a lot of good actors. But the thing I've noticed is that a lot of people, especially young people, they really respond to something about you. It's more than just the acting. There is a word that I find used a lot is fresh or freshness. Have you ever sort of sat down and tried to deconstruct that or decode that? Or what does that mean?
Because in fact, I get that all the time. So people are constantly telling me, Alia, you have to look fresh, young. And I'm like, yes, I'm young. And I feel like I'm fresh because I've showered and I've left the house.
Okay.
I don't understand what fresh means.
Okay.
But I think, honestly, the only thing that I want to be as a person, as an actor, as a celebrity, as a public figure is myself.
Right. Okay.
And maybe that is fresh.
I think so. I think you and particularly this sort of generation of actors that you belong to, it's interesting that you say yourself. Because for me, one of the most fun things to watch about people like, you know, you, Varun, Arjun, all of you, is you're very authentic in comparison to, say, like older stars. And I mean that with no offense to the older stars.
I think the time then was different.
Right, of course.
Because there was no social media. There was no Insta stories. Mm-hmm. There was no prospect of connecting with a game. And there was no, there was a lot more mystery.
Right.
So I feel right now, maybe the new thing is to be yourself and not create a mystery about yourself.
Right. Okay. Fair enough. Because it's also harder to be mysterious in like age of social media,
like,
right?
Hey, like, spotted here, spotted there,
yeah,
leaving gym, going to airport.
that's, you guys actually have something called an airport look. This is something that I found out. Please explain to us what an airport look is.
Means you're spotted, you're going to the airport, you're catching a flight. How do you look? That's your airport look.
Wow.
It's fun, I think. Yeah, it's nice to see different airport looks.
Yeah, because literally the only decision I have to make while going to the airport is I have to choose the most comfortable boxers because it's going to be 9 hours in economy. So I'd better, that's it. That's my airport look. My airport look is an internal thing.
But it's how you make comfort look fashionable. So next time you arrive in your boxers to the airport, look, then that may become a trend.
But that, I feel like nobody's going to take photos of me. Like when I get out of the airport, even the immigration guy is sort of like, I don't know if I should take your picture. Like,
no.
Even
you're famous
like
now,
Rohan.
Come on.
I'm like semi-famous. Yeah. I'm like semi-famous. I'm only famous as like your and Shaheen's friend.
No.
Like,
listen, you were on Coffee with Karan. You are definitely famous.
I was on Coffee with Karan though in the jury episode. Like, which everybody
but you
knows.
Were there?
Is like, that's true.
You were the finale episode.
I was the finale episode.
I thought Badri will be the finale episode, but you all took
the
finale.
Yeah, then I was on the finale. It was pretty cool. I got a hamper and everything. It was very exciting. The other thing that I want to ask you about is that sort of freshness and that brand and that being yourself. How does that translate into the game? What if that sort of came to the game when you met Mark and you met that team?
So, interesting story is I met Mark and Moonfrog and Tane, everybody. We were, strangely, I met them in Goa.
Right.
Because I was shooting for Dear Zindagi at that time.
Right.
And Vivek called me up and he said that, Vivek is, from Matrix. And he said that, we have something really fun and exciting. Mm-hmm. And, we want to come and see you. And whenever somebody comes to an outdoor to meet me, means it's something really special.
Right.
Because that doesn't happen very often. Mm-hmm. And we met. And the first thing that I think I said to also Mark is, I mean, as we all know, a genius, a legend.
Yes.
So I was firstly honored to be in the same room as him. And the first thing that they said to me, I think, was that we want this to be Alia Bhatt's star life.
Right.
But it's not only about you.
Right.
The
okay.
game is about the audience. It's about the girl or guy who checks in as the main star, actually,
right.
And I'm their friend.
Okay.
So the star life is not my life, it's your life.
Right, okay.
And I wanted to make it about the other person because I can't be that pompous person, ki mujhe dekho, main itni badi star hu. I can't be that way.
Mm-hmm.
I've not been brought up that way. But I do find it important or exciting that I can connect with them and be their best friend virtually.
Right.
I mean, today is the age of virtual, it is the virtual reality or whatever.
Absolutely.
And so, I mean, the fact that I could have a game in which I could connect with them was outstanding.
That's something to consider for the future, a virtual reality version
of
this game. Where it's just like, today you can play with Edward. That would be a fun thing of the game.
Step.
Which sort of brings me to my next question, because when you met with Mark, and this seemed like fun, obviously, I know, and this comes from knowing you a little bit, I know you're not the sort of person whose prime driver is money. Like, it's not just about money or this, that, or whatever. So what about the game, really, aside from just the fan thing, what about their pitch made you go, this is what I want to do?
So, number one, life simulation is a genre.
Right.
So, number one, that genre for me, that's the only way I think I can be a part of a game.
Right.
Through
life
simulation, right? And, I mean, anybody who is, and I've always said this to my mother as well, that I don't only want to be, I don't want to only be known as an actor.
Right.
I want to be able to have different layers to me as well, being a part of a game, whether it's producing some content, creative content someday, whether it's singing, whether it's, social work or whatever it is.
Right.
I want to have those many layers to myself.
Okay.
I want to be like a big chocolate cake with a lot of layers of icing and gems and... Sorry.
I can already see the clickbait headline. Alia Bhatt reveals which cake she would like to be. Click here to find out.
So obviously the idea where I could be a part of a game where it's not about me, but about the other person was something that I jumped to right away.
Okay.
And what I also really enjoyed was that they came up with these like dummy versions of me in, in my dresses, and fashion is a very, very big part of this game.
Okay.
So that's what I enjoyed the most. And as a child, we would love playing games like that. Hum apna khud ka avatar design karenge, aur fir isko ye kapda pehenna padega, ye, she wants to go here, she wants to go there. And what I really liked was Moonfrog themselves and Mark, they said that, okay, we want to involve you in it. So we want to like put your cat in it. So Sheba is in the game.
Oh, nice. So one of your cats is actually in the game.
Yeah, Sheba is in the game.
Right.
And so is my voice. We spent a lot of time where we were cracking the right tone wherein which I actually, you actually feel like I'm there with you in the room.
Nice.
So it's not
okay.
Like, hey, aaj kya kar rahe ho? It's almost like, hello, what's up? What's happening? You
right.
know, like, come do this, do that. Like the way I'm talking to you right now.
It's not that, hi, we are happy to help you. Not
exactly.
Okay.
It's that's, not that.
That's important.
That's a bit creepy.
That's, is there, is, am I in the game? Am
you. Not right now, but you could.
Thanks.
You never
thanks,
know.
Thanks so much.
It's
I
an ongoing
so loved,
process, this
like, just
game.
Just guy in background. Like that
no,
be-
and also we also discussed about how if there's something, say that I have a movie premiere coming up, I have some exciting
right.
event, we can actually put that in the game.
Oh, nice. Okay.
So it's also, you know, they want to, so we, like, we I shared my whole schedule with them. Like, this is what
right.
I'm doing. These are the clothes I like wearing. This is the hairstyles I like doing.
Right.
Things like that. So it's actually in tune with my life.
Oh, nice. So cool. And did you play a lot of games as a kid? Yeah, there's this fly that is obviously your biggest fan that has just not left your side since we started. But did you play games as a kid, or do you now on the phone like to sort of?
See, I'm on the games, but I can't play games that frustrate me.
Okay.
I need the games to calm me down.
Okay.
So I do play games, like,
right.
you know, I've played Farmville, I've played,
right.
like, Candy Crush and stuff like that. But for me, when I'm going through my hectic life, I need a game to relax me or to basically, you know, most importantly, to time pass, make
right.
use of your time, but
right.
in a relaxing way.
Sure.
And which is why I said to them as well, I said, let this game be not frustrating, like, let
okay.
it be simple.
Right.
And they're
right.
like, no, don't worry, it's going to be really simple and very smooth. And it's like you're walking through, you know, your life, but
right.
virtually.
I'm glad you said that, because does this happen to anybody else here? It happens to me all the time when I'm playing frustrating games, where I'll be again, too graphic, I'll be sitting in the loo, I'll be sitting on my couch, and I'll just be playing this game, and I'll be thinking to myself, you know, I've had a good year, I've worked hard, I sort of take care of a business, I have a good relationship with my family, I'm a good person, I think I've achieved a lot in life. Then I'll be playing, and then that one pig will not die. Or that one, this thing will happen, and my instant reaction would be like, "Tu kya hai? Tu kya hai? Tere se ye bhi nahi hota. Matlab tu kya? Matlab jhand insaan hai tu." Like that. Does that happen to anybody else? Where if you mess up a level in a game, you're just like, "My life is only not worth living."
Yeah.
Like it doesn't matter what I've achieved. It's just
can't
this. My life
way.
Is pointless.
Especially when you're a competitive person. Like I will
exactly.
compete with my father. You know,
right.
like I will compete. If we have to win something, we will make sure we win.
Right.
So I'm not. Winning, then it's a problem.
Then, yeah, exactly. So that's why you're like, take this competitive element out of the game. So what is that something that your fans will respond to in the game? What do you think they are going to take away from this? Like,
I mean, I hope they take away an experience.
Right. Okay.
I mean, it's not like I don't get, I don't communicate through my social media platforms,
mm-hmm.
but I can't always respond to everybody, and my heart breaks when I can't do that, because I mean that would be I would be doing that, nobody would be seeing me in any movies.
Correct. I mean, I don't think you'd be able to respond to it, because last I checked, what, you are India's most successful star on social media.
I would not say most.
I'm saying look, let's just be blunt in terms of pure numbers. You're talking to a guy who's built his career on the internet, and our entire point of envy is we just go and we look at your followers sometimes and we're like, it's not fair, yeah. this is not fair. Apna pura life internet pe, lekin like we have 2 million, and then whatever followers we have, you add 2 zeros to it, and you get Alia's social media followers.
No, no, no. I'm honestly I feel very grateful and flattered that I have those many followers.
Okay.
It seems, I mean, a bit surreal sometimes.
Right.
But as you rightfully said, I can't sit and respond. It's not like I don't want to. I do try to do
Fair
a chat
enough.
Session every now and then. But I feel like anybody who checks into this game will be able to hear my voice, will be able to see the videos. And again, it's not about me. It's
right.
about you.
Sure.
You know, and it's not like, come, I'll give you a piece of me. It's not also about that. It's
right.
just like, come have an experience, and whilst you do that, I'll be your friend. You
nice.
Know, we could be friends. And it's not like I'm saying, none of you are my friends. I literally have love and affection and pure like gratitude for everybody who says good things or bad things about me. Because
right.
even
okay.
bad things sometimes make a difference,
Fair
you know,
enough.
In
yeah.
a good way.
Sure.
So yeah, I think this is in a sense a way of connecting and just staying in touch, and another medium of communication.
Nice. Okay, so before we talk a little bit more about the game, I have one more question for you about movies, which is that I mentioned you did just March to March. You have done 4 huge films that have sort of come and gone. And so there was Kapoor and Sons, Udta Punjab, Dear Zindagi, and then Badri. So when you're working on all these movies simultaneously, how do you keep your head straight? Like, how do you not show up one day on the set of Udta Punjab just as Kyra? Like, how do you keep it straight?
You know, it is very difficult, and okay. That's where the director comes in place. So fun thing is I was shooting for Dear Zindagi and Badrinath Dulhania a little bit simultaneously. So the first schedule was that Badrinath Dulhania, I was doing some extra subtle acting. And Shashank was like, Alia, what are you doing? So it became like a fun thing where he said, Alia, not Dear Zindagi, Fear Zindagi.
Right, okay.
So whenever I was doing a Dear Zindagi kind of acting, mm-hmm. He used to come and say, no, Fear Zindagi.
Right, this we need to go to the other space. We need to go to the other zone.
Yeah, but you, that's where your director, your co-actors and everybody comes in, you know, in helping you. Because honestly, it is very, very difficult, which is why I like doing one film at a time. But you can't always do one film at a time.
So Dear Zindagi is something that I actually want to talk about more than any of the other movies last year. Because for me, what was really nice about watching Dear Zindagi is it felt like a space that Indian movies don't usually go towards, which is this sort of idea of this person who, if you look at it as a normal Hindi movie, it's not that much conflict. You can look at it and be like, is ladki ke life mein problem kya hai? It's just love problems which everybody else has. But I like that it takes that and it turns it into a sort of conversation about mental self-care and mental care, which is something that I don't think we do a lot of in India. And is that something that drew you to the character?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, we know this, you and I, we have a common person in common who has suffered through depression and who is not afraid to talk about it.
Yeah.
My sister, because that the whole idea of being afraid to talk about there's something wrong with the way you're feeling is the idea that I feel we need to get rid of in the society. Dear Zindagi was maybe a subtle, sort of more lighter way of approaching without being preachy, because you know whenever we try to be preachy, people run away in the opposite direction. I would do that as well. I don't want to hear a bhashan from somebody.
Sure.
But if somebody's giving me a sweet kind of a representation or a subtle representation of how people actually feel, they may not need to be a really big problem, but you can be feeling a certain way. And I feel like we should start talking about it like it's a cold. Like, you know, because it's as common as a cold. And I really, really like that about that character and that space and how she just develops this friendship with her therapist. I mean, Jahangir Khan is totally fictitious. He does not exist. He's not, you know, I mean, I don't know anybody as cool, as sexy, and as cool.
Yeah.
And living in a great little cottage in Goa. But, I mean, a lot of the things that we discussed, I did relate to. And I'm sure many girls out there related to as well.
All right, fantastic. So before we talk a little bit more about the game, and I'm going to get Mark and Tanay up here as well, we have a little promo video that we'd like to show everybody. So here we go with a promo video for... sink low. All right, that looks great. And it is available on the Play Store and on iOS, so for everybody to get. And to discuss this further, I'd actually like to ask Mark and Tanay to join us. Please, round of applause for them. No more introduction. Good morning. Yeah, I know, right? Here we go. Okay. Photo in 5 minutes. First questions, then photo. Done.
Pakka denge photo,
Mangesh. Pakka.
Bahut zyada.
Done. और अगर फोटो नहीं मिला सर गेम डाउनलोड कीजिए आलिया है गेम में स्क्रीनशॉट लेके छाप दीजिए कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है कुछ टेंशन नहीं है कुछ गेम खेलने का टाइम नहीं है सर क्या बात कर रहे हैं बम्बई में हम सब ट्रेन लेते हैं सर गेम खेलने का टाइम तो मिलता ही है सर क्या बात कर रहे हो 2 घंटा मिनिमम तो दिन का ट्रैफिक में जाता है ओके सो मार्क आई लाइक टू स्टार्ट विद यू टेल अस अ बिट अबाउट द गेम एंड व्हाट एग्जैक्टली डू प्लेयर्स डू इन द गेम इफ आई स्टार्ट प्लेइंग द गेम व्हाट वुड आई डू व्हाट वुड हैपन
सो यू'd फर्स्ट स्टार्ट ऑफ with beginning your career.
Right, okay.
First you're gonna meet Alia and she's gonna say, hey, can you help me? I've lost my cat.
Right, okay.
And then Sheba, right, that we talked about.
Yeah.
And then you go through photo shoots, you go through meeting a director, she helps you out getting your first big break.
Nice,
you get
okay.
a manager, you get a publicist, you start becoming part of the Bollywood industry.
Right, okay.
And, you know, it's not only about the gigs that you do, but it's also about the fashion, it's about all the people that you meet, and navigating your way through the drama that can sometimes be associated.
Obviously. Right? I mean, and there's obviously some creative liberties you've taken with the game. It's not super realistic, right?
Oh, yeah, no, because it's the fantasy, it's the fun part of
okay. Because otherwise the first 15 levels would just be, level one, go stand outside this bungalow in Warsaw for audition.
Right.
Level two, 10 hours later, go stand outside this other bungalow.
Right.
So you've cut that part out.
We like to say we give the film version fantasy of what it's like to be an actor. Not okay. all the hard parts, right? That wouldn't be fun.
That would be fun. Yeah, that's true. That wouldn't be fun. And where did this idea come from for this particular route to take with the game?
Sure. So like Mark mentioned earlier, when we were talking and brainstorming about what we want to build for India about a year ago, we thought about the life, the story-driven life simulation style of game, and it's a genre that is very popular around the world, and we wanted to build it with Indian content, and of course, Indian movies and cinema are such a big part of all our lives that it was natural that we build a game like this for the India market, and we couldn't think of anybody better to work with than with Alia, who totally gets this, and it's a pleasure working with her.
That's pretty awesome, and how long has the game been in development? Because it looks like something you took your time with. It looks like...
We've been speaking for a long time with Ali as well. And we started building this game about a year ago. It's been in development and testing for about a year now.
All right. And Mark, what was it like trying to get Alia's look right in the game? Because there's entirely too many games in this world with very creepy, not... natural-looking characters.
No, I have to say they've got my looks bang on.
That's why.
Like right now only, this I remember I wore during Dear Zindagi promotions.
Right, okay.
This look I wore during Dear Zindagi promotions, and that I wore during Kapoor and Sons promotions.
Mm-hmm. Wow, you really do know your fashion. Like, we literally wake you up at 3 in the morning, like, when did you wear this outfit? And you'll know.
I remember.
So if you guys look at...
There are a few things that I know, and I know them very well.
Fair enough.
What we started with, obviously, was looking at pictures on the web of Alia. And if you look at all the different pictures, you find out she has a very elastic and expressive face. And that's a good thing. But it makes it very difficult to try to nail that one look in the game. And I think we probably did 50 iterations.
Right, okay.
Over a period of time, and the artists would try, and we're like, no, that doesn't look right. No, her cheekbone's not right. No, her lips aren't right. And we just continued iterating, until finally we got the look. And I remember it's like, that's it, don't change it. Don't change it at all. And then the other thing is the expressions, because if you get a still face, that's one thing, but then when you have to do all the different expressions, it gets another challenge. So our artists loved it, because they can continue to work on our face again and again and look at pictures. That's a really fun thing to do, right?
Right.
So it took a period of time. And, you know, we had a series I think we sent you and said, pick the one you like best, right?
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, so
did you have any inputs or feedback and be like, no, not that, not right now. Did you have any, like, actor feedback going, no?
I think they got my wardrobe pretty bang on. It was just about getting the face and the hair and and the figure.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say. They were like, no, you have to change this.
No, but this figure is a little dreamy as well. This is how I would love to look. I don't really look this way, but that's what we said, right? It's about the fantasy. It's about what you can achieve. So
this is cool. So if I ever do appear in the game, six pack,
whatever you want.
But you're very fit right now, totally.
You can do that, right?
You can cover your boxes as well.
Done. Nice. Yeah. I'll be in the background again. Guy with cat. So what, were you guys nervous when pitching to her for the first time? What was it like when you met her? Like she said, you went down to Goa.
Yeah, so I've worked with actors before in other games.
Right, yes.
And I don't know if it's the same in Bollywood as in Hollywood, but sometimes, actors could be a handful. Right?
Yes.
You never, like a box
what?
Of chocolates.
Actors can be a handful?
Shocking. You never know what you're going to get. You never know, right? And so we had a great meeting. And the thing that impressed me the most, really, very gracious, unpretentious, down to earth, everything we've been saying, very, very friendly, but also gets it, right? And that was the key thing because, understanding, have that meeting of minds to say, here's what we want to do. Here's how games work. It just flowed. So it was great.
All right. So since you mentioned that you have worked with other actors before, you've worked with James Earl Jones and Ian McKellen. What was it like meeting the voice of Darth Vader? Was there ever a moment where you were just like, record this for my answering machine?
He was in one of the games that we made at Westwood. I didn't actually get to meet him, but in the game, that voice coming through is amazing. It adds a deep sort of seriousness to it. Now, Ian McKellen and the other folks there on the Lord of the Rings set, right?
Right, yeah.
It was both wonderful, but it was also a little frustrating. I'll tell you why. Because when you sit across from the table and have lunch with the hobbits, and they're talking about the party they went out and had the night before, you're like, you're a hobbit, but you're a person. But you're, kind of breaks that reality.
Don't break the illusion for me.
Real? Oh
yeah. Or you see a guy they named Tall Paul, who is the stand-in for Gandalf when he's standing next to the hobbit, and he's a 7-foot-tall dude just lumbering around the set, right?
Okay.
So it's kind of... it's good and it's bad because it breaks that reality. So when we see the film afterwards, you're like, oh, I know those walls of Minas Tirith are styrofoam.
It's like, I know what that hobbit ate for lunch on the day they shot that scene.
We had eggs. We had eggs together, cool. Right? Yeah.
And besides, so you said getting her face right was a huge challenge. Is there anything else about the development of the game that was, say, particularly frustrating or something that you spent a lot of time on to get just bang on right?
Yeah, even the tech, right? I mean, we've built this game to be optimized for the India market. So spent a lot of time in making sure that the game works really well on small-end devices. It has a low data footprint because that's what users care about. It's a game that you play while connected to the internet, so it's important for it to work seamlessly in poor network situations. And the team has worked really hard to make sure that there are no glitches, that it plays smoothly, and at the same time being one of the smallest data footprints and size games from tech perspective.
All right. Cool. And Mark, what was it like for you to develop a game specifically for the Indian audience, like you said, with all of those technical challenges, aside from that, to sort of culturally to make that shift?
That was it's new and fresh, fun for me, because it's a challenge. I hadn't done it before. I think, you know, building a game, you have to really take into account what the audience wants, things that they know. I like to say that, you know, when you make a game, you're kind of giving something that people already remember and know.
Right.
And I didn't know the Indian culture and audience. I had to learn a lot about Alia and her life. And I really, you know, the technical aspects, it's easy for me.
Right.
The cultural aspects had to rely on everybody else. And usually, we actually came up with this term. We need more masala in the game, right? Does this feel Indian enough? Right?
No, but need more masala is the best way to, I think, depict an Indian.
Anything Indian.
Even
with food, our first instinct is always more masala. Always.
So that was the term that came up. And I relied on everybody else to obviously, you know, coach me through that process of learning.
Nice. Superb.
And obviously, like we talked about, not the first celebrity you've worked with. Are you looking forward to doing more stuff with the game? What do you want? Are you going to do?
It kind of pointed to you. Looking forward to doing more stuff? Of course. Yeah, so this is, you know, when you first launch a game, that's only step one.
Right.
Because games as a service, we continue live, we continue to develop. And we talked about events in Alia's life, things that are coming up. Of course.
All right, fantastic. I think that about covers everything else. Is there anything that you would like people to know about the game, Mark or Alia?
I think we can open to questions.
You can open to questions?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Photo lena hai? Photo? Okay.
Wait.
Pehle photo le lete hai.
Photo.
Okay, so we'd like to thank Rohan and Alia, obviously also Tanay and Mark. And all of us have just dreamt of being a star. Now you can actually live the life and you have Alia by your side. So that makes the journey all the more exciting. ग्राउंड एक्चुअली स्कूल में मैं काफी गेम्स खेलती थी मैं हैंडबॉल टीम में भी थी मैं टेनिस भी खेलती थी स्क्वाश भी खेलती थी फुटबॉल भी खेलती थी अभी समय नहीं मिलता है गेम्स खेलने का बट एवरी नाउ एंड देन वेन एवर मतलब एक डे ऑफ होता है तो मैं और अपने फ्रेंड्स हम लोग बैडमिंटन खेलते हैं अपने फ्रेंड्स के गार्डन में और मुझे एक्चुअली स्पोर्ट्स खेल में बहुत मज़ा आता है बिकॉज आई थिंक वो एक नेचुरल फॉर्म ऑफ एक्सरसाइज है आपको पता भी नहीं चलता आप 3 घंटे के लिए खेले जा रहे हो आपका वर्कआउट भी हो जाता है एक्सरसाइज भी हो जाता है और आप एक बहुत ही पॉजिटिव फीलिंग भी आती है तो एक्चुअली इफ आई गिवन अ चॉइस मैं हर रोज खेलूंगी बट टाइम नहीं मिलता है.
या गुड आफ्टरनून, दिस फॉर लाइक टू आस्क यू दैट व्हाट इज द विजन ऑफ दिस मोबाइल गेम ऐप.
आई मीन देयर व्हाट इज द रीजन फॉर डूइंग एनीथिंग, क्योंकि आपको एक अपॉर्चुनिटी मिलती है, देयर इज एन अपॉर्चुनिटी वेयर यू कैन एक्सप्लोर समथिंग दैट इज न्यू एट द सेम टाइम वेयर इट हैज़ अ पैरेलल टू योर लाइफ. ये एक नैरेटिव एडवेंचर है सेट इन द एंटरटेनमेंट इंडियन इंडस्ट्री. एंड फॉर मी बोथ दीज स्पेसेस आर रेलिवेंट एट द सेम टाइम फॉर गेम्स बिकॉज हमने बचपन में खेला है एंड इंडस्ट्री बिकॉज आई बिलोंग टू द इंडस्ट्री. एंड व्हेन यू ब्रिंग दिस कॉम्बिनेशन टुगेदर आई थिंक इट्स अ ग्रेट कॉकटेल एंड समथिंग दैट आई वुड लव टू एंजॉय.
Hi, Alia. Hi. Hi. Business World. What's up? So, my question to you is that how will you engage with your fans with respect to the game?
So basically, as I rightfully mentioned earlier, we sat and we've actually recorded my voice. So when you read the text on the game, there will be my voice along with it to support it. So that's for me number one. Communication through audio is the most, I mean, the best way you can do in a game like this. And that's what we've done. And also, we have shot a couple of videos as well. So if it's your birthday, I'll wish you happy birthday. If you know, you're doing well, I'll tell you you're doing well. So things like that. And I mean, of course, I mean, that's the most obvious way through which we can communicate. And as even the dressing, you know, we have over 250 design avatars, clothes, accessories that we've particularly put out there so that people can design themselves. And these are all through my personal likes of fashion and all of that. So, yeah.
So, and those are just the starting points.
Yeah, those are just the starting points, I think.
The game is going to continue to develop and grow. So there'll be all sorts of new opportunities as we go forward.
देखिए द रीजन आई ऑल्सो वोर दिस टी शर्ट टुडे इज नॉट क्योंकि मैं आज इसके बारे में एक पॉइंट करना चाहती हूँ. दिस गेम इज ऑल अबाउट पर्सनैलिटी. तो अगर मैं आपको वर्चुअल सेंस में अपना पर्सनैलिटी दिखा रही हूँ तो ऑब्वियसली व्हाइल आई एम हियर टुडे एज वेल देयर हैज टू बी अ शेड ऑफ माय पर्सनैलिटी नॉट जस्ट मी. तो उस वजह से एफ फॉर फेमिनिस्ट.
आलिया द क्वेश्चन इज दैट विल देयर बी देयर आर थ्री क्वेश्चंस. फर्स्ट वन फॉर यू, विल देयर बी रियल टाइम इंसेंटिव्स फॉर फैंस एज वेल फॉलोड विद द ऐप. As in, they get to meet you or something like that for the fans in the end. Are you looking at it? Mark, the next question is for you. What is the vision with the mobile app that you have in the long term? And how do you see the celebrity app market in India per se right now? Okay. Thanks.
You want to answer?
You should answer both the questions okay. Since you're the creator of the game.
So let's talk about the long-term vision, right? The great thing about this style of game, this genre of game, is it's story-driven. And we continue to add new chapters to the game as we go forward. So anything going on in Alia's life can become part of the chapter experience of what players are playing there. And talking about real-life interactions, that's up to stuff for us to work out, right? And we'll see, and it's, you know, Alia's got a very, very big, busy schedule. So it kind of depends on how we can all put this together. Making a game, there's a lot of work that goes on behind the scenes. It's a little different than just showing up and doing a live interaction, right? The celebrity game app sort of market going forward, the thing that surprises me, actually, is that India has such a rich experience with Bollywood and all the other regional film industries, and I'm kind of surprised there's not more games like this already. Right, and because people really engage, want to engage with their favorite actors and actresses. So I think there's a big future for it.
Hi, Alia. Hello. Hi, Alia. पीछे पीछे. बहुत खूबसूरत लग रही हैं. App में भी खूबसूरत लग रही हैं.
Thank you.
आपके मतलब बड़े बच्चे सभी fans हैं मुझे लगता है, लेकिन इसके बाद ज़्यादा fans हो जाएंगे. थोड़ा सा अलग सवाल पूछूंगी मैं.
जी.
रामनवमी बहुत ही जल्द आने वाली है. रामनवमी, नवरात्र शुरू होने वाले हैं, रामनवमी आने वाली है, लेकिन राम मंदिर का मुद्दा अभी तक सॉल्व नहीं हुआ. आपका एक रिएक्शन चाहिए था.
ओके, मैम ऑफ द मीडिया, विद ड्यू रिस्पेक्ट आज के हम सारे सवाल आज के इस इवेंट पे अगर हम सीमित रखें तो थैंक यू.
सॉरी
आलिया, आपके सामने. हाय.
अरे आज इतनी देर से इतनी देर से कैसे? पहले तो क्वेश्चन आपसे ही आता है.
बिकॉज़ ये सब मेरे भाई बंधु हैं.
ओह वेरी नाइस.
तो आलिया, ये आपका गेम मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि ये हॉलीवुड के किम कदासियन से मिलता जुलता है, तो हम ऐसा माने कि आप उनको टफ कंपटीशन देने वाली हैं, या ये गेम आने के बाद लोग उन्हें भूल जाने वाले इंडिया में, ऐसा हम माने?
हाँ, मिलता जुलता होगा, क्योंकि जैसे कि मैंने कहा ये जॉनर है, मैं किसी को कॉम्पिटिशन देने की कोशिश नहीं कर रही हूँ. एक्चुअली ये सिर्फ किम कार्डाशियन ने, ब्रिटनी स्पियर्स ने भी, डेमी लोवाटो ने भी ऐसे गेम्स बनाए, क्योंकि जैसे कि मैंने कहा एक जॉनर है. और ये मेरी तरफ से फॉर माय इंडस्ट्री एक गेम है जो मैं एक जॉनर यहाँ पे ला रही हूँ. जैसे कि हमने दिखाया कि दिस इज इंडियाज फर्स्ट नैरेटिव एडवेंचर गेम, तो कम्पीट करने की कोशिश नहीं कर रही हूँ, बस कनेक्ट करने की कोशिश कर रही हूँ.
हमने सुना है कि इसके बाद आप एक लंबी सी छुट्टी पे जाने वाली हैं, तो आपको नहीं लगता कि आपके फैन जो है वो नाराज हो जाएंगे या रोने लगेंगे?
क्यों? पहले तो मैं लंबी सी छुट्टी के लिए नहीं जा रही हूँ, मैं इधर ही हूँ. और अगर जाऊंगी मैं तो मैं मतलब 8-10 दिन के लिए जाऊंगी, बट दैट्स ओके. आई थिंक वो लोग एक्साइटेड हो जाते हैं क्योंकि मैं जाके खाना वाना खाती हूँ वहाँ पे.
थैंक यू.
एंड ऑल्सो अगर वो जा रही है तो ऐप में उनका साथ है.
Hi Alia, this side straight. Hi. Big Hi. Congratulations for Badrinath Ki Dulaniya.
Thank you.
A message well delivered. Recently we got to know that just like you, there are many actresses who sing. Jaise aap filmon mein gaati hain, waise aur bhi actresses they sing too in the films. But you're particularly not happy with a few singers. And you just the report says ki aapko lagta hai ki unko singing nahi karke acting pe hi concentrate karna chahiye. So just wanted your reaction to it.
Who's not happy with a few singers?
You.
What? Who am I to be unhappy with singers? Main ek actor hu. I have never said anything like that. And I mean, if I am an actor and I am singing, I only support other actors to sing.
Okay, thank
you. If they can sing.
Thank you.
I don't know, you made me Sonu Nigam. Like, I am taking over this.
Hi, Alia, this is Priyanka. You're taking a 4-month break from acting before you start with Dragon. And you're obviously going to learn a lot of things, you said. But is it an easy decision for you? Was it very, very easy to take this decision, considering you are at the peak of your career?
I'm not taking a break because it's just my schedule is as such that I've got a break. Because this schedule is not going to start until much later. So by default, I have a break. So instead of pushing something in, like pushing a film in this break, I'd rather take the time to learn things that I've not gotten the time to learn, like dance and singing and cooking and spend time with my cat. So I'm going to do all of that.
Members of the media, last question, please.
Hi, Alia.
Hello, hi.
आपकी सिस्टर शाहिन ने अभी एक पोस्ट किया है सोशल मीडिया पे, जिसमें उन्होंने कहा है कि मीडिया जो है फ्यूनरल पे पहुंच जाती है और प्राइवेसी का इन्वेजन होता है, जिसे आपने लाइक भी किया है, वरुण ने भी लाइक किया. डू यू हैव एनी कमेंट टू ऑफर ऑन दिस? इस पर आप क्या कहना चाहेंगे?
Just like this platform is not the right platform to talk about this, the same way a situation like that is not right. It's not right to be accosted by pictures and videos, keeping in mind the sentiments of the people involved. That's it.
Okay, members of the media, firstly, thank you for the questions. And secondly, we have a surprise. I'm not telling you what the surprise is. I'm going to request Alia to tell all you members of the media. So you're seated, please be seated.
आपके सीट के नीचे देखो, कुछ आपको मिलेगा.
सिंस वी टॉकिंग अबाउट आलिया भट्ट स्टार लाइफ,
किसने बोला ये? नहीं.
Okay, jisko bhi chai ka cup mila, you don't win anything.
Kya
but yes, you
Hold
have five stars.
Hold up the stars.
So the few people with the stars.
Yes, whoever's got the stars, can we please
jo
request?
Jo bhi jinke paas star hai, upar aa jao stage pe. Jinko star mila, niche. Kisko mila? Arun ko nahi mila niche star. Arun khud hi star hai, correct baat hi hai. Haan, so whoever got stars can come.
Yes, please join us right here. We have something that we'd like to give you. So please join us here, right near the podium.
What is this? Oh, koi mobile nahi.
There's two more stars. There's two more stars.
Photo frame. Right?
Yeah. test, test. Guys, there's two more stars out there under the chairs.
Huh? Yes, there are two more stars. Please check. Maybe.
There's two more stars.
Somebody stolen the stars and gone away. Mangesh ne liya hoga ek star. Kidhar gaya? Wo ekdam bhag gaya hai. Okay, anyway. Okay.